Last time on True Magnum TV.
Up and down is perfect, but you are to the left.
I'm out,
be out like you'd be out just like you'd be like on a, like a zebra.
Hey, Cole, find out if Babasho picked up his rifle this morning. He shoots, we have a problem, and then we get back to camp and his rifle's in camp. I would be very upset.
Oh, God! That's over.
I wanna go grab Brady, let's get out of here.
Hunting season has begun. And these men will put it all on the line for the hunts of a lifetime. This is True Magnum TV.
True Magnum TV is proudly presented by Western Powders, premium shooting and gun care products.
High in the mountains of Tajikistan, Beau Morgan and his team are on their final hunt day for Markhor, and their client John's gun never arrived at camp.
When you're traveling and your luggage gets lost, it's unfortunate. You have no control, we just gotta work through it. This is our first paying client. We have to be successful, even if it's with a borrowed gun.
Only one male there right now. This morning, that one, probably some more females. Yeah, but probably some more females in this hole.
We spotted a male in here that's pretty promising, got the right age class. We need to get closer, take a good look, and if he's the right one, shoot.
We're gonna drop in this valley. Kind of where we come off last night.
Bruce, come on.
I would. We're not gonna climb so hard. We do stop. Just stop if you get boiling. Well, got kind of chilled sitting there, huh?
Hunting in a new area is tough, especially when everything is riding on the success of the first hunt.
Time to wait and see has passed. We've got to make our move. There's a valley here, it's got enough brush. They've moved in so they can't see us. I think we got a little time. Get up the mountain, it's straight up all the way, but it's the only way, so.
Going 1,000 meters straight up. Getting to a point where if they work their way across, we'll be in a good spot.
These dense and deadly mountains seem almost impossible to climb, but the rocky passes and gorges are the only way to access the Markhor.
This canyon's starting to pinch. It's 350 across here now. It's kind of a white trail. Markhor made that. All the moss is gone.
I've worked with Renault for over a year now on this conservation project. It's taken a lot for us to get here. We got a lot invested in it. And it's not just about us, it's about the community we're supporting, and we really need to find a way to have success here. Keep bringing dollars back to these rural areas and help these people control the poaching.
After 3 hours of hiking up the deadly terrain, the team needs to reassess their location.
To the close cliff, 1,000 yards. The yellow.
823.
Are you trying to get a bow? Is that what you're doing?
At least get, you know, as they feed across, we're probably gonna hold up. So if we get up to this deal, back across would be nice.
We're pretty low on the mountain still, not quite where I want to be, but it's time to get, we're getting close, it's time to get John prepared.
I'll probably give John the gun. Let John take the gun. You have one more bullet put in, three below, one in. When we get into this, John, I'll give you a range, sorting out, Renault's confirming. Which animal? I'll get you a pack, get you set. You don't shoot unless you're totally happy.
Yeah.
You know?
The only thing I'm worried about now is when we get ready to shoot, if John's confidence there to make the shot without his own gun.
Mm-hmm. While on the trail of a monster elk in Utah, James Brion's once-in-a-lifetime hunt was abruptly ended due to injury.
I'm not gonna lie, that wasn't a lot of fun. But at least that part's over. Got some new parts in my leg and ready to go again. Bad news is they're still saying I'm gonna be down for 12 months. We'll see about that.
With a new hunt scheduled in 6 months, James is back home in Montana and determined to speed up his rehab time with physical therapy.
Now it's time for the rehab.
You know, when I fell, I knew it was bad, but this isn't my first rodeo. Last time this happened, I was back on the football field in about 5 months. That was 25 years ago. I realized things could be a little different this time around.
We got you covered, James. Hey, James.
Hi, Jen.
How's it going?
Got the hard part over.
Yeah, that's true. Well, we'll start on the bike today, and then we'll just kind of review some of your post-op precautions and things, and just kind of give you our plan of care from here.
Okay. Sounds great.
This time it isn't about whether I can play ball again. It's about whether I can continue to make a living doing what I love to do and always have. Will I be able to make my next hunt? It's only 6 months away. The stakes are a lot higher this time.
Just to kind of review what was done, he kind of quoted your difficult case, which I have to agree with.
A lot of factors come into play during the rehabilitation of an ACL. In James's situation, he originally had an ACL which failed. The good news is they were able to save the meniscus. This means he will have a lesser chance of osteoarthritis in the future.
So that means as soon as I'm done with the next 6 months, I'm good for 30 years?
Yeah. Well, keep our fingers crossed. That's the hope.
Yep.
Yeah, it should help prevent you having to get the total knee replacement in the future.
You know, if there's one thing that I've learned, is that we as sportsmen just take our bodies for granted. And at the end of the day, they have to be dialed in just like our optics, just like our guns. I mean, I can't do what I do at half speed. That's not an option.
So when's the next big hunt? Are there 8 months away?
August.
Where are you going?
Russia.
Oh, nice.
Normally, it takes 6 to 12 months for a person to return to normal activities after an ACL repair. This hunt doesn't sound like a normal activity at 12,000 feet. So I know James is very anxious to get on this hunt. We'll see where we're at in about 6 months.
No elbow land. You're resting here.
I don't feel any pain in there. It's just a matter of getting those muscles that are mostly gone to do anything.
One more. Take a rest.
I think we're off to a good start here, but I'm realizing that there's a long road between here and the mountains of Russia.
True Magnum TV is brought to you by Cooper Firearms of Montana. Hornady, accurate, deadly, dependable. Eberly Stock, go in light, come out heavy. Prairie King Ranch. Global Rescue. And by Jonas Brothers Taxidermy Studios of New York.
In Tajikistan, Bo Morgan and his team now have their client John in range of a trophy Markhor.
The trees and then the base of the big cliffs is 360.
360.
Actual. It'll fall, drop 8 inches. It won't pop open. I leave mine open. I shut before I pull the trigger.
With only a couple of hours of practice under his belt with a borrowed gun, John is a bit hesitant.
Man, that's tight. That's close. You knocked that down.
Yeah.
I'd rather be down than have it back. Because you knock it down, you're firing. I like my own gun.
You do.
I'll keep my hand.
At this point, John's pretty skeptical about this gun. It's borrowed equipment. Understandably, you're not going to be that confident. When it's push comes to shove, I'm 100% sure he can make the shot. But John's got to be ready to make that shot.
Okay, Renault, from the others.
25, 30 meters to the right, down at 4 o'clock.
He's right in the gut of the gun. He looks like a rock.
You have to shoot.
First, I want you to see where he's at.
Yeah, I can't see him.
Stop. We have to show him. So, the white rock to the right.
Well, I don't see the white rock. Oh,
the ones on the right.
Right, yeah.
And then you're binoculars, go down to 4 o'clock. There's a real white boulder in the draw.
Uh-huh. Got him.
See him?
You got him?
Yeah. You see the horns, very black.
Very black horns,
yeah.
Except there's a bush in front.
A bush?
Not right, but him.
No, I think you're all right on his chest. You're all solid.
All right.
Yep.
In Zimbabwe, Rob Dunham and his client Kirk are halfway through their African safari. After missing two zebras, Kirk's confidence has been rattled. Now, with the sights fixed, Rob's plan is to get Kirk back out and on the game.
Zebra. My nemesis.
These zebras have got into Kirk's head. And with two of them right there in front of him, this is his chance to break that jinx.
Impalas, they're looking here. So,
the impalas?
Yes. They'll run. They'll run away.
Everything will run.
Yes.
But today, there seems to be many eyes watching the savannah.
Prey animals all group together for mutual protection. And if one of them bolts, they all bolt. And this stalk is over.
They're walking now.
With the animals on the move, Rob and the team must now try and keep pace without spooking the animals and hope they can get close enough for a shot.
Around the corner.
They're just walking away.
The zebras have moved quicker than expected. By picking up the pace, the team risks spooking the animals or ending up too far behind.
They walked across the road on their own earlier. This female's rebuck's gonna screw us up though.
In Tajikistan, Bull Morgan has his client John within shot range of a trophy Markhor. One missed shot with a borrowed gun, and the hunt could be over.
All right.
Yep. Starting down.
He's down.
Yo!
Kaboom.
Yo!
Hey.
Yo!
Woo!
Woo!
Make sure he's tight. Yeah.
He pole axed him. Damn him right off there.
I'm really impressed by John. Through this whole hunt in general, he didn't have any of his own equipment, gun especially, kept it all together and pulled it off.
That was
woo!
A little adrenaline.
Yeah,
pumping hard. Nervous about the gun.
Oh, I know. Wow, we did this, man. Give me a hug.
Congratulations, man.
Thank you. Cool. I'm just quivering. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Hey, what up, bud? Go.
Wow. Well, cool. Let's go take a look, huh?
And Bo knows this victory runs deeper than just the hunter.
So nice. These guys work all year, too. They get to see him tip over.
And it's not just about killing the animal. It's about all the other 11 and a half months that they're here putting food on their table. And, and finally, they see something for it.
Absolutely amazing.
So it's coming together for them in a huge way.
Big bass.
Yeah, he looks big here.
And this is money, how it twists so much. This is really, instead of just going real slow like this the whole way, if it just turned once here.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. You're a good man.
No, I want to thank you guys for an amazing hunt. Renaud, your knowledge of this is incredible, and Bo, your expertise also.
I think it's
just shows how the program's doing so well. You know, the age class, the animals, and the conservation effort. It takes dollars on the ground to support all these people all year to protect them. This is the kind of things that everybody should pay attention to and model, you know, hunting programs after, I think. So we've been really blessed in this deal because we've got a closer look here. We might have the potential world record. We'll get down tonight and throw the tape on it. And it's just great when everything comes together and that kind of icing on the cake.
Oh, that's just icing, yeah. You know, you just hope for a nice representative of the species, and this is beyond that.
This is my trophy, is a nice picture. Go on my den and sit and look at that and go, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Life gets crazy and go, I want to go do that again.
True Magnum TV is brought to you by TrueMagnum.com.
In Zimbabwe, after hiking 2 miles over rocky terrain, Rob and his team have finally caught up to the zebras they've been after. Because of the number of animals around the zebras, the team has had to do much of the stalk out of visual contact, trusting entirely on their guide's experience.
London seen the impalas, saw them coming up here. He's thinking the zebras follow them or vice versa, so we hope they're in this next drainage.
Maybe they're in the next drainage. Being a successful guide is knowing the land and your hunting terrain. And in this case, I've got complete confidence in Fidelis and my crew.
Zebra, we finally found them. Let's go down, down.
Okay, just wait. This one's gonna just come out here. Follow this. Okay, settle.
Oh, girl, my girl. I really hate those zebras.
Zebras. Oh, that is excellent.
Finally.
So don't hurt your ankle. It won't go anywhere.
Boom, boom. Are this just too cool? Wow.
You're good with that?
The end of the zebra jinx.
They're just beautiful.
All I'm thinking is please, please don't miss. If Kirk would have missed, it might have been over, but he totally redeemed himself.
No, you went from like with the hero to zero, you said, and then you...
I redeemed. The zebra jinx is off.
Yeah.
You're begging the trend.
Back on track. Yes, we were.
We've had a great few days and we have a lot more to go yet.
Next time on True Magnum TV.
The wind was bad back there. These sable, there's about a dozen of them single filing.
There's lots of bush between us.
He's moved now. See, the back one is kind of orangey brown.
Okay.
That's him.
And then once you're up here, you're going to try to go into
the same
forest.
Everything you tell me to do seems easy and then it's hard. It sounds hard.
As soon as we're getting ready to go here on the big ibex on this side, that's why we're kind of excited here. We've been to the dance so many times ourselves, but when you're the hunter, you get these butterflies. Oh.